two of the week, and I'm going to do another mixed bag for you because I quite enjoyed that. But focusing a little bit on the abs, okay? So mixed, but maybe a leaning towards abs. How does that sound? Because we all need a little bit of extra ab work, don't we? Come on, you admit it, we do. So let's get cracking, guys. Make sure you're set up, your room is nice, you're happy, you've got your door closed. Good. So one red, two blues. And let's just take a second. Let's focus. So lie yourself down. Now just take a second to yourself to shut that world out. Just readjust in your mind. This is time for you now, okay? So you've done your stuff, you're good. This next hour is all about you. So breathe in and breathe out. And every time you breathe out, just try and let go of any thoughts that's just buzzing around your brain, maybe stuff that's going on in your life. Imagine they're just like bubbles that are just floating away and popping. Just let them all disappear. Breathe in and then breathe out. And every time you exhale, just visualize, imagine everything just floating up. Just trying to get yourself in a more focused, calm mindset. And now let's focus on the core. So keeping your mind relaxed, your body relaxed. Now focus on the core area just below your belly button and squeeze it tight and breathe in. And again, breathe out. This time hold your core tight, but still imagine you're breathing out, you're letting go of any tension and stress, anything you don't need. And again, big breath out. One more, big breath in, relax your shoulders. Hold the breath in for a second, squeeze your core, and now exhale. Let it go. Toes are on the foot, but have a quick check to make sure you're lined up. And then push yourself out and bring yourself in. Whatever pace works for you, depending on how you're feeling. Good. It's nice to just go with the flow, isn't it? Don't try and stick to too many rules. Just go with the flow. If you feel like you want to go fast, then just go for it. If you feel you just want to go slow, that's absolutely fine. We're doing it, and that's the main thing. We're doing it, guys. We're doing it. Okay, now sink your heels under. Good. And up and in. So out, under, up and in. Lovely. Now this is a wonderful stretch. Really deep stretch. Don't underestimate the power of this stretch. And you are also strengthening all the way up the back of your legs. Around your ankles, all those muscles and little bones are getting a little maneuver in your feet. So this really helps with your posture, your stability, right under, up and in. So working around the ankles and the small bones in your toes and in your feet, so powerful. Good. So give it the attention it deserves. One more, under, up and in. Now push out, go into your walking. Now maybe start off slow at first and just check that your knees are coming up in line over your toes, in line with your hips. Belly is sucked in and tight. Suck it in, girls, suck it in. Relax your shoulders, your arms. Still just trying to let go of any kind of distracting thoughts that are buzzing around your brain. So nice deep breathing. Exhale any of that stress. Let that shit go, baby. You don't need that. And now up on your toes, under with your heels, up, under, up, under. Okay, I know these are burning. They're burning me too. But we got this. 5, 4, 3, okay, 2, 1. Bend, come in, stretch. Ah, switch and stretch again. Wonderful. Okay. Great job, guys. Now switch your spring if you want to. for an extra little challenge. One red, one blue, and one yellow, okay? So switch the blue to a yellow. So that's just increasing it slightly, but not too crazy, all right? So grab your weights if you wanna use them. If you prefer to squeeze through the circle, then reach for your circle, it's no problem. I'm gonna do weights today. So on the toes, arms up, straight ahead, okay? I'm gonna shuffle down a little bit because we're gonna do a nice wide arm opener if you've got the space, if not down as usual. But I'm gonna shuffle down so I've got enough movement around my shoulders. One leg in tabletop. I forgot. So arms wide, leg stays in tabletop. We're gonna be changing this up without moving the leg. Without switching the leg. So just bear with me on this. For the start, let's just get used to this arm movement. Nice and wide, and then up to the top. Wide and up to the top. You've got one leg in tabletop. Good. Excellent. Good. Now, next time you come out, straighten the leg and then bend. Straighten and bend. Good. Straighten and bend. Remember, focus on bringing the carriage in as well as pushing the carriage out. Don't rely on those springs. Nice, tense, strong core. Those arm muscles are switched on. Now, I'm gonna do two more, then I'm gonna add a little extra. So one, same leg though, two. Good, now this next one, push out, straighten the leg. And two, down and ups. I don't know what to call them. All the way out, leg goes straight. Tap down on your toe onto the footbar twice and then back up. There is a, my brain has just forgotten what that's called. A kick, it's called a kick. Okay, straighten the leg, kick twice with a straight leg. Back into tabletop as you come back in. Oh my God, what's wrong with me? All the way out, so your leg is straightened and your arms are out. You're gonna hold the position and give two big kicks. And in, oh yeah. Kick, one, two, bend and in. Open, one, two, bend and in. We're gonna do two more. Straight legs, point your toe. And back into tabletop, last one. And one, two, come on, tap that foot off the footbar, good. Okay, oh my goodness. Kick, Kelly, it's a freaking kick. Arms are up, leg is in tabletop. Shuffle down again, engage your core, push out, open the arms, keep the leg in tabletop. Good, wonderful, awesome job. Now, this is my last reformer class in this studio, because tomorrow I'm packing all my studio stuff up and moving it into my new studio in Enfield. Oh, yep, that's what's happening. This is my last recorded class in Ballymoney. Oh, okay, I'm gonna try not to think about it. Now, straighten the leg up to the ceiling and then back in. Arms wide, legs straight, pop, pointed. Toe your point. Oh my goodness, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone. You might actually get a proper teacher. One who knows how to speak. Okay, point your toe straight and your leg back up to the top. I'm sorry guys, I am so sorry. Oh, okay, two more and then we're gonna add the kick. Two. Next one, kick, one, two. Now kick with determination. So straighten that leg, down and up, nice and fast with no bend on that knee whatsoever. Come on, go for it. One, two, oh yeah. And straighten, one, two, good, really fast, awesome kicks. One, two, like you're doing Irish dancing. Come on, get those Irish dancing moves going again. Let's do two more. One, two, I've never done Irish dancing, can you tell? One, two, and bend. Oh, okay, I'm nearly done. Okay, stay on them springs. We're doing great on them springs. Let's stay on them springs. Okay, so we're gonna do leg up towards the ceiling, arms up towards the ceiling, and we're gonna push out and bring it in. Now this leg is gonna wanna start wandering, and you ain't gonna let it. It's gonna stay up straight. Now we are gonna move these arms in a minute. Good. So, drop the arms halfway down. Keep the legs straight. Good, don't let it drop down. Run up as high as you can get. This is good for your flexibility as well. Now drop the arms further down. 5, 4, come on, keep that leg up. 3, you're doing great, guys. 2, 1 more, oh yeah. And swap it over. Okay, straighten the leg, straighten the arms. Just check your foot's not crept into the center. It can feel a little bit off when you have to put it, when you put it near the hip, but that's really important. Are you ready? Go. Arms stay up, leg stays up. Oh, my leg keeps wanting to bend. Okay, straight leg, pointy toes. Okay, we've got this going. Are we happy? Yep, good. Arms down, halfway. Halfway point to your arms, good. Keep looking at that foot. Make sure that's a solid leg. Good, 2 more, and then we'll drop the arms even more. Good, drop the arms down further. Perfect. Watch that leg, that's better. Squeeze your core. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And relax. Give your ankles a roll. Rock from side to side. Release your back. Okay. Well done. Okay, I'm gonna go straight into some abs. Okay. I'm gonna start you straight off with the badass ab move to get them abs woken up, and they're gonna go, woohoo, what the heck is going on? And then we're gonna layer it up with some moves that you're already used to. Okay, so now springs for you, I would recommend 1 red, 2 blue. But if you're not finding that giving you the edge you want, change it to 1 red, 1 blue, and 1 yellow. So start off with 1 red and 2 blues, but if you're just not digging this one, you'll soon work it out. Okay, so can you see I'm kind of gone the wrong way on the reformer? I intended to do that. So I'm facing the wrong way, and it's a bit annoying because my head kind of wants to go down into the springs, but that's a good thing because now my belly is working to keep my head and shoulders up. I'm going to put my legs very gracefully into the straps, and I'm going to try and not remember the last time I did this in a hospital. Legs in straps, the long part of the straps. Good luck getting them in the short part. Oh, I need to lay down. Okay, so below your knees, okay, just a couple of inches below your knees. So now you've got a hefty spring going on there, so you're gonna lift your head and shoulders up, so now you're in a crunch position. Okay, so your hands are behind your head and you're lifted up. Oh my goodness, I can't talk and do this at the same time. I'm gonna have to breathe. We're gonna do crunches. You're gonna lift up and bring your knees in, roll down, and knees go out. Now there won't be much movement. Look, see this? Woo! So you're pinching in the middle and then back out. Up, down, up. Oh my goodness. Okay. That's a badass move, yeah? Okay. I'm gonna have to stop talking when I'm doing this. I'm gonna try and do 10. Stop and do another 10. Are we up for that? Have you all got your positions? Lie down. Legs in tabletop. Hands behind the head, head and shoulders up. We're gonna go for 10, and I'm gonna shut up. Let's go. 1. Oh. 7, 9, 10. Oh my God. Oh. Okay, how did you do? Are you all right? Okay, you've got 10 more in you? Are you getting what I'm saying? Yeah? You're body is coming up and your knees are coming in, and then your body's going back down slightly and your legs are going out slightly, but it's a small move. But boy, can you feel it. Let's go. Hands behind your heads and knees in, head up and down. 3, 4, 5, come on. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, let's see. Okay. We're gonna do sideline ones a little bit. Oh, I'm just gonna have to take a break. They really get to me. Okay, so legs in tabletop. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring the arms over to the side and pull slightly on that knee. And then over to the other side and slightly pull on the same knee. Is that okay? We're gonna do 10, which means it's just 5 each side. So you got this, yeah? Legs in tabletop, 2 arms to one side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ah, I hate them. Oh my goodness. Right, bring yourself out. They're horrible. Did you think they were as horrible as I did? Am I just being a big baby? They really hurt. Oh, man. Maybe it's my reformer. Yeah, Kelly, yeah. Okay, oh my goodness, drop your foot bar for me. Keep your springs where they are. Oh, no need to maneuver them. Just lie down. Oh, just lengthen your stomach out, because that's tough. Stretch through your stomach and take a couple of big breaths right deep into your belly, good. Okay, legs in tabletop, arms down by your side. We're gonna go into good old toe taps. So we drop down through the hip. We don't flap around the knees. Okay, none of this knee flapping stuff. You are dropping from the hip and you're keeping the same angle throughout the whole move. Good. Dropping at the hip and bringing it back up to tabletop. Don't bring your knee right into your chest. You're not doing these right into your chest. You're keeping them, your knee above your hip and then dropping it down. So that keeps a slight core engagement the whole time. If you bring those knees into your chest, it relaxes your core muscles, okay? Take a break. Breath. Back up and go again. Tap, tap. Oh yeah. Simple, but effective. One of the best moves in Pilates, because it gets your upper and your lower abs. Good. Well done. 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And relax for a second. Take a breather. Good one. Okay. Hands behind your head, legs up to the top, straighten your legs and go into your scissors, okay? Scissors, scissor it out. Straight legs, one down, one up. Nice long legs. Good. Good. We're gonna go straight from this into your swimming. So, lower the legs halfway down and little bats. See that? Yes, as if you're swimming. Woo! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bend the knees, relax. We're gonna do the same again. So scissors, nice and wide. Swimming, small and fast. Halfway down, halfway up. As low as you can go, but don't be putting too much stress on your back now. Okay, legs up straight. Arms behind you, holding onto your headrest. Keeping the knees straight and the toes pointed. Scissors. Woo! Now, not too fast, slow and controlled, keeping the length through the legs the whole time. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Halfway down. Come on, little swimmers. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Okay. Lift the foot bar up, change your spring to a yellow. My ball, is back. Woohoo! Ball behind if you want it to be. It's up to you. Personally, I actually don't really mind it there or not, but it's up to you. Excuse me. Oh, lower back spot. Sorry, I'm choking. Arms forward so you're onto the front of the carriage. Bring both of your feet on the toes on the footbar and just push out and bring it in. If you're sat too high up, this is just nothing, darling. This is just, you might as well be drinking wine and eating a spice bag. No, no, no. You've got to tuck under slightly and roll back. See the difference? Yes. If you try and take that, if you take that ball away and hold yourself without that support, you're getting a better workout. But if it strains your back in any way, put the ball there. It's no big deal. Okay, you're doing great, guys. Now, lift your arms up higher than shoulder height and keep on going. Come on, squeeze your belly nice and tight. Hold that core engagement the whole time. Your spring is loose, so your legs really aren't doing much work, but that's the whole point. This is about balance. Good. 5, 4, 3. Bring your shoulders back. Don't go too rounded. 2. Last one. Woo, they build, don't they? Oh, they build. Okay. Now, you take a break and breathe into your stomach. And breathe out. Breathe into your stomach. Good. So you're stretching all the way down through your abdominals and your obliques. Just a little stretch. Good. Get back into the same position, but this time, can you get down a bit lower? Oh, yeah. And push out and bring it in. Yes. So a little bit lower this time. Now remember, if you roll your shoulders really far forward, it's just not great for your neck, guys, okay? And it's certainly not good for your posture. So bring those shoulders back and you'll feel instantly that work in your abs even more. Good. Good. Oh yeah, I'm feeling this. 5, 4. Lift your arms if you want. 3, 2. Shoulders back. Give me one more. And relax. Okay, well done. Excellent job, excellent job. Should we give the abs a little break? Okay, give the abs a little break. Okay, so we are going to, what have I got you on? I've got you on a yellow sprint, perfect. Onto all fours, knees under hips, wrists and shoulders. Now, if you want, you can bring yourself right down onto the carriage or up onto your shoulder blocks, whatever feels good for you, depending on how long your arms are. I'm going to go down to the carriage for this one. And then bring one foot behind you and pop the toe onto the footbar, push the carriage out and bring it in. Now your yellow spring is nice and light, so you are really dependent on your back to stay balanced. Good. You thinking, this is a bit easy. What's she doing? She's going in too easy on us. Okay, well, bring the opposite arm out. So now you've got the opposite arm, opposite leg, up. The foot is pushing away through the footbar and still keep your box position in your spine. Good. 5, 4. Come on, keep that arm up. Don't let it drop. 3, 2. Well done. 1 more. Beautiful job. Okay. Swap it over. 2 hands down to start with. Make sure you're squared off. Good. And off you go. Out and in. Beautiful job. Keep that core nice and tight. Nice and tight. Oh yeah, nice and easy. You ready to make it a bit harder? Opposite arm, whatever you do, don't try and use the same side arm as leg. No, wonky donkey alert. Opposite arm, bring it out, come on up to shoulder height, but keep the spine strong. Use your core muscles, not just your back. Your back's working Anyway, you're supporting your back with your very well toned core. 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one. And relax. Sit back onto your heels. Bring your hands, your arms through the center of your shoulder blocks. Drop your head down and go into your child's pose. Release your lower back, keep your head down, take a couple of nice breaths. Oh, beautiful job. And back up. Fabulous job, my dears. Wonderful. Okay, we're going to do a little bit on the legs next. So I want you to use the box, please. So bring the box short ways across the reformer, okay? Drop your foot bars down and change your spring. Oh, I think it's on your yellow, so keep it on your yellow, that's perfect. And if you don't mind, grab your circle and nice and safely get onto your reformer. So remember, always put your foot onto the solid part first, never onto the moving part. Then bring your second foot up onto the moving part. Arms out your head. Let's stretch it open and bring it back in. Let's just loosen the hips. Stretch through the inner thighs. Good. Now add a squeeze into the circle, but just hold the squeeze. Don't squeeze on my knees, just hold it. Feel that working through your chest, your pecs, and just hold the squeeze. Open in, close. Now get a bit wider if you can. Good, and bring it up, yes. Wide, and good, keep on squeezing. Good, wide, brilliant. Doing fabulous. Squeeze your core for me, please. 3 more, 1. 2, 3. Okay, now squat down. Now stick your tailbone out. Okay, so stick your booty out behind you. And glide across and back. Glide across and back. Now this leg here, you can straighten it out if you want, but it depends how balanced you're feeling. Because you're in your squatted down position, you'll be knocked off your balance a good bit more. There's a lot more going on with your thighs. So your thigh muscles are going, ah! Okay, which is good. Engage your core. Good. Sink it down, okay? Good. Keep nice and low with this one. Nice and low. Out and in. You should be feeling it about now. Let's do 5. Squeeze through that circle. Get those arms going. 4. Keep low. 3. Good. 2, fabulous, last one, good, okay, pop the circle down, stand up straight, we're going to just loosen out through the back, so push the carriage out, hold the carriage out, drop down, all the way down, now hold this position, and loosen through your lower back, and then bring it back up, but roll it back up, good, so you're pushing out, stabilize so your legs are working, your core's tight, drop all the way down. Hold on to the carriage if you want, but I want you to really drop down. Hold it, and then work your way up, holding this position still, and then bring it in. Good. So you're going to your wide splits. You are maintaining that wide split position while you roll down. Focus. Roll up, try and keep the carriage stable, and then together, one more. All the way out, when you're feeling stable, drop yourself down, release your lower back, come on, big old stretch, good, and then up, and then in. Okay, let's do the other side, foot off, try not to swizzle around and risk breaking your neck, guys, please. Naughty, naughty. 1 foot on, 2 feet on. Grab your circle. If you're more comfortable with your weights, that's okay. arms out. Let's just loosen this side. So open and bring it all the way out, all the way in. Good. When you're feeling comfortable with this one, now we squeeze through the circle. Carry on going, but get those arms involved. Good. Keep that squeeze on the circle. Don't let it release. Brilliant job, guys. You're doing fabulous. Let's do three. Come on, get a bit wider for me if you can. Two. Good. Wider. Last one. Good. Down onto your knees. Not onto your knees. Bend your knees. Don't listen to me. Bend your knees into a squat as low as you can go. And then out and in. Keep your core tight. Slow and controlled with these. Don't race through them. Keep your tailbone sticking out. Good. Come on, get a bit deeper, a bit lower if you can. I want those legs screaming at you. Oh yeah. Squeeze your circle. Five. Four. Three. Squeeze your circle. Two. Come on, last one, all the way. Brilliant. Circle down. Stand up tall again. Open wide. Drop it down. All the way down. Hold in that position. Roll your spine. Then bring your leg in. Really try and keep that nice wide splits position. Rolling down. Hold on. Then further if you can. Good. Roll the back up. And bring it back in. Let's do three more. All the way. Down. Roll her up. And in. Good. Hold this position. Drop it down. All the way up. Control the carriage. Last one. Good. Roll her up and bring her in. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, well done. Sitting on the box for this next one. So you've got your yellow spring on, which is absolutely fine. So reach behind and grab your straps. Okay, hands into your short part of the straps, sitting onto the box. Now focus on getting a nice straight spine, shoulders back and down, squeezing your sit bones together, engaging your core. Bring your arms forward. You're going to reach forward as if you're pushing somebody away from you, and then bend your arms back. So push away and back. Forward, back, forward, back. But keep your spine absolutely still. No movement, just your arms. Good. Now let's just do one arm and back. Other arm and back. Oh yeah. One arm, back. Other side, back. Two more each side. One, back. And last one each side. And back. Good, take a break for a second, give your shoulders a roll. We're gonna go into arm circles, okay? If your yellow spring is a little bit too tight for your arm circles, just reach forward and switch it onto your blue, that's absolutely okay. Okay, so your arm circles, arms are straight out in front of you. Nice straight arms. And I want you to lift them up towards the ceiling, out to the side, down, and then forward again. Up, slow and controlled, out to the side, and then forward. Up, out to the side, and then forward. Beautiful job, nice and slow. If you've slipped it down to that blue spring, guys, you can probably afford to go a small bit faster than I am, but I'm playing it safe, keeping it nice and slow, and I'm really feeling it in my biceps, and I'm feeling it in my triceps too. And this is also brilliant for your mobility. So forward, up, and around. And relax. Well done. Pop them straps back onto your shoulder blocks. We're going to remove the box. We're going to do a little bit of leg work in the straps. So pop your box down. Okay. And change your spring to one red and two yellow for me. So a pretty hefty spring. One red and two yellows. Now have your circle, handy. You know you love it when I say that, don't you? I can hear you all cheering. Yay, the circle, we love the circle, Kelly. Yeah, I know. Okay, stick your feet in them straps and start whinging at me, okay? So you've got a heavy spring on, so be careful. Oh, if the heavy spring's not suiting you, change it to one red and two blues if you want, or one red, a blue and a yellow, it's okay. The one red and two yellows, it's pretty tough going. So, feet are in straps. You're lifting them up, you're pushing them down, okay. Ankles together, knees together, legs straight. Lifting them up, pushing them down. Okay. Now let's just stretch out through the lower back while we're doing this first. So lift the legs up, pause for a beat, and then allow your legs to carry on going back, back, back. Bend your knees slightly if you want. You'll feel a big pull in your lower back. Enjoy it and then push it down. Just do a couple like that. So lift them up and then allow the ropes to pull your feet back, keeping your knees straight first and then bending your knees in just so you can release that lower back and then down with your legs. And again, just allow them to go back and just naturally pull through your spine. Good. And then back. Now, keeping your tailbone down now with these ones. Up and down again. So tailbone down, core tight. Let's get some speed going on. If you've chose your heavy spring, you'll be feeling this in your legs after five or six of these. Come on, increase your speed. Let's do it like you mean it, girls. Do it like you mean it. Okay, let's go. Let's get that heart rate up. Come on, let's get some movement going. Pretend you're on the jump bar. Like being upside down in midair on the jump board. It's actually not like being on the jump board at all. Okay. Just nice and fast, legs straight. Woo! Are you feeling it yet? Five. Come on, speed up. Four. Straight down. Three. And again. Two. Last one. Oh my goodness. Okay, grab your circles. I can't reach it. Oh crap. Okay. Oh, I got it. Oh dear. Okay. Okie dokie. Between the ankles, just above the ankle bone. Oh my goodness. Oh, that's a heavy spring I've put you on. Yeah, I'm sorry. Okay, squeeze through that circle. And again, just up and down, but with a squeeze through the circle. You'll feel this really dive. Oh man, this really shifts the muscle groups. To focus, woo, on your thighs. This is a real thigh cruncher. I love it, it's brilliant. Oh my goodness, absolutely fantastic. Go for it. Come on, squeeze through that circle. Let's do three more. One, two, three. Now up and hold. Squeeze and release. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Down to the foot bar. Oh, I know it's burning, but go anyway. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh my goodness. Is it possible to hit yourself? I hit myself right now. Okay, squeeze, release. Up to the top. Go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Down. Okay, 10 more. My goodness. Go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, drop the circle. Oh my goodness. Oh, they're awful. I'm so sorry I make you do them so much in class. They're horrible. Okay, let's go. Leg circles. Oh. Leg circles. Up. Splits position. Down and around. Okay. We're doing good, guys. We're doing great. You've totally got this. Nice wide circles. Let's see if we can make those circles a little bit wider. Come on, get your flexibility. Oh, let's go for it. Let's do five. Ooh, four. Three. Two. Give me one more, then we'll reverse the circle. Brilliant job. Okay, so down to the foot bar. Splits position. Up. And then down again. Go easy. You've got a tough spring, so just go easy. You don't have to go fast. Good. You just have no idea how good this is for your hips. Oh, this is keeping you so flexible. This is really giving you a big bonus. Oh, people who don't ever do these kind of movements, of which there are most people, they get so stiff as they get older. We must keep moving around the hips. Do me two more. One. And two. Okay, halfway down, halfway up. Heels together, toes apart, frogs. So when you bend in, let them ropes go in the center of your knees and then straight out. Bend it in, push it out. Now you can go slow or fast. But just let the knees go nice and wide and then forward. Staying in that same plane. So halfway down, halfway up, heels together. Core tight, relax your shoulders and your arms. Really good, guys. Let's do five, four, and three. Nearly there, guys. Two, put one more for me. Brilliant job. Take your feet out of the straps. Oh, pull the straps behind you. Just bring your knees into your chest for a second. And let's just cross at your ankles. And just rock from side to side, releasing your back. Stretching through your legs. And then the other way. Cross over again. Lovely job, guys. Brilliant. Okay. Yellow spring. We're going to end on core again. Okay. Yellow spring, ball or no ball, it's entirely up to you. We're going to do the same again. 2 feet on the foot bar, holding to the front of your reformer. Tuck and roll under slightly, shoulders back and forward. In. Good. Now, hold your bellies nice and tight, really support your lower back. And again, remember, if you're using that ball, it's okay, just use it as your lower lumbar support. Oh yeah. Okay, arms up. Bring those arms up off the carriage and roll it back as much as you can. Holding that core engagement in your belly. Your legs will be feeling this as well because we've done a good bit of legs just now. So it's a light spring, but you'll be feeling that in your legs. Five, four, three, two, and one. Well done, guys. We're going to do one more set then, and then we can stretch out. So I like to just bring your arms behind you, head back, and that just opens up through your stomach. Big breath into your belly, and then down. Just stretches and opens out through your belly for our last set. Okay, feet up, really roll into it, okay? Just staying in this position, you should be feeling it. Arms straight up this time, come on, let's get those arms off. Straight away, oh yeah, really good. Good, your chin isn't tucked into your chest. Remember, your neck is in that neutral position. So you're not looking at the ceiling, but you're certainly not looking at the floor. Nice neutral position. Keep pushing those shoulders back. You will feel as you push those shoulders back what that does straight away to your abs. Make some work. Five, four, three, two, one. Oh man. Okay. That was good. Move your bits and bobs away. Okay, change your spring to your blue. Okay. Let's give it some stretches. Let's go into your mermaid sit. So I'm gonna put my left foot forward, my right foot back, and my left hand on the foot bar. Oh, stretch out, right arm up and over. Just give it a nice stretch and then twist and stretch deeper, pushing out through your arms. Brilliant, bring it back in. Oh, then the other side, left arm over your head. Oh, good stretch. And then let's do the other side. So now your right foot is forward and your left foot is back. My right hand is on the foot bar. Push, bend into it. And now twist into it and drop yourself down, stretching through your arms into your shoulders. Breathe, relax your core. Stretch. Good. Carriage in. Right arm up and over. Oh. Sitting forward on your carriage. Really, two hands behind you. Straight into that nice big arm stretch. Oh, that's a good one. Bring the carriage in and give your shoulders a roll. And then do it one more time. Stretch. Hold it for a beat. And then bring it back. Oh, good. Knees onto the carriage for me. Let's stretch those legs. Always check your stable. One foot in the center and back. Now let that stretch through your hip flexor muscle as well. And then bring it back in. And just sit in it for a second and just look up to the ceiling. Arch your back so you're feeling a bigger pull. And then swap over for me. Push away again. Good. And then bring it in and just pull. Oh, good stretch. And then, woo! Try not to fall off the carriage and you're done. Okay, guys, so the next class I do for you, I'll be in my next studio, my next PT studio, anyway. So, okay, wish me luck, and I'll see you all next week.